हेलो गाइस, चलो गाइस, लेट्स बिगिन टुडे। यू गाइस कैन हियर मी? कैन एनीवन कंफर्म?
आई कैन हियर यू आशुतोष।
ओके ओके ग्रेट। चलो लेट्स स्टार्ट टुडे। एक्चुअली आई एम क्वाइट बिजी, आई हैव वन मीटिंग अगेन, सो विल बी अ बिट क्विक टुडे। ओके लेट्स बिगिन द वेबिनार। ओके, विल बी अ बिट डिफरेंट फ्रॉम अदर वेबिनार्स इन द सेंस आई वॉन्ट डू अ लॉट ऑफ टॉकिंग। बेसिकली विल जस्ट गो थ्रू, run through the markets. Oh my goodness. Just a minute, guys. Yeah. Yes. I send it to my room. That's good amount. Yeah, 5 million anyway. You know, 5-10% also. If you bring in, that will be good amount of savings on that. Okay. What time? Seven 30 will be a stretch. I'm actually already busy with something personal. Let's do one thing. Let's have them in the conference room by 8:30. Okay, I'll be there. Yeah, no, just send it to me. Yeah, okay. I'll go through the presentation. I won't take much time. Okay. Just send it to me. Okay. Just highlight it. Highlight it. Okay, this highlight, you send me a separate presentation, not the one you are going to present. So send me one presentation with the things you need to highlight, okay? That's fine, brother. 5 million is not that big amount also. It's just okay. Chalo. Send it to me, okay? See. Yeah. Take help from Ali. Yeah, and don't knock me, okay? I'm busy with something. I'll come out around 7:38. We'll, in the car only, we'll read it, discuss it, and by 8:30 we'll be ready, okay? Great. Thank you. Chalo. So guys, let's start with the US market. This entire week, you know, if you see the weekly candle, okay. Now see, one thing we'll have to be considerate about the US market for today has not yet opened close. So we are a bit early and we don't know how this candle will close. Okay, so that would be one point of, you know, what to say, which will be missing in this week's webinar. But we can still take some cues. Okay. What we can... What we can do here is that if this candle, you know, if this closes like this, if this is how it looks, you know, the US market, even by the end of the day. Okay. That means for next week, we're still not sure what can happen. It might happen that market goes down again. Okay. If this candle closes in green today, say US market goes up, closes somewhere around, you know, above 4,500 or something. In that case, we can assume that the uptrend has again started. Okay. So what message we'll have to derive at the end of the day. So if US market say closes above this 4,500 levels, that will mean that, you know, the uptrend has resumed and then next week ahead, we can see again a new high. If it closes the same like this, that means we can still see some further consolidation until this trend line is hit. Okay. And if you ask me, mostly this is the probability. What I'm also expecting currently is that, you know, US market mostly will dip down. One way to get an idea is we can see the futures, what US futures are doing. We can see what US futures are doing. That will give us a bit of idea. Why is it connected?
So I think it was there in the first drop down US side.
No, that one is delayed after this. That's another thing, right? This is delayed. Let's we can see it on investing. So like say, like I mentioned, you know, I'm expecting it to go down. This is also down. Mostly what we will see that the US market is doing is it will you mostly close down. Okay, it's already negative. Okay. Futures are also negative. That's what my expectation is. So I'm already last week I said that, you know, the structure on most of the indices is not very bullish as of now. All are looking bearish. Those were not in late wave terms, not a impulse wave structure, rather corrective waves. And that's the reason, you know, we saw the fall in Bank Nifty. That is the reason even this is falling. And what my expectation is that next week will be a little bit chaotic on the indices and we can see a further drop in the coming week also. Okay. So the outlook for next week will be to avoid getting trapped on the highs. Okay, the outlook will not be to go short. The outlook will be to avoid getting trapped on the highs. Idea will be to get long again once the uptrend resumes. Okay, in an uptrending market, strong uptrending bull market, there is no point, you know, taking the risk of getting short. But since the short-term outlook is bearish, we will avoid being short, but will obviously not go long. Okay, once that shorting is complete and the trend resumes again, we'll go long. So that is the idea.
Sir, okay, so should we also look at Dow Jones?
It's fine. S&P 500 is fine. Dow Jones is just industrial stocks. It's not the entire US economy. Okay. And then US tech is another only tech companies. Okay. That is NASDAQ. So only S&P 500 is all you have to look. You don't need to look all of it. Now coming at the dollar index last week, when the dollar indexes went up, that was also the outlook last week, which we presented. We'll have to see where it closes. Okay, but yeah, like we discussed last week, this is still in there's a very strong supply zone that dollar index has. So even if it goes up, which looks like it will for even the coming week, okay, aligning with the equities markets bearishness, it might at max go up to these levels of 93.5, 94. Okay, but not beyond that. If it starts going above that, then it becomes an issue for us. But until it stays below this 94 zones, okay, the bullishness or inequity use market will continue. And we could just be looking at chances and opportunities to go long at each and every fall. Okay. So next week again, this is also dollar index is also kind of confirming that yes, we can see certain bearishness again coming in, setting in the equity market for the next week. Okay. That's the view on this. Crude oil, like we discussed last week, looks strong, behaved strong, still is looking good. Okay. Now, for crude to continue its up move, it needs to close above 55,400. 5,500, okay. 5,500, 5,400. That is, this is the level that crude needs to close above for it to continue moving up. Okay, once it closes above 56, 55, 50, 5,600, then we can as say with 100% confidence that we will see a new high in crude. Okay, new high, not all-time high, new recent swing high, you can say. Yeah. So next week again looks like crude stocks will do good. Okay, crude bearing stocks and wherever crude will be a raw material, those will not. So that's about it from the global markets. Let's move on to our own indices. Okay. Let's start with Nifty. So Nifty has already closed today, right? And this is the candle it has formed. Okay, like we discussed last week, Nifty is still bullish. Okay, the structure in Nifty was bullish, and that's what it confirmed. Whole week it remained more bullish than as compared to Bank Nifty. Bank Nifty did perk up in last 2 days, but that about it, and that too has already given up almost all the gains. Okay, and that will continue because the structure in Bank Nifty, like we discussed last week, was not a bullish structure. It was a corrective structure, and the new high that has been made, and like we discussed, would only be an opportunity to sell. How many of you guys actually shorted Bank Nifty? Anyone? I have actually shorted Bank Nifty. Okay, I have already shorted 38,200, 38,300, 38,400, and 38,500 call options. Today I have shorted them. I'll be holding it. Okay, Nifty. I cannot yet say Nifty is negative, but yes, if the globally the outlook turns negative, Nifty would also underperform. It might not turn bullish, but we may see a sideways momentum. It might not fall, but we may see a sideways momentum in Nifty for next week before again breaking out to make new highs. So that's the view on Nifty. People who trade in Nifty, for them, they should remain cautious in terms of not getting trapped on the highs. Yeah. And if you buy Nifty, you might look at a bit of, time correction before you see again a new high. So Nifty, the outlook remains bullish, but wait for, some confirmation and some breakouts. Only trade now on new highs. Go long only on new highs. Okay. Or if only if there is a breakout. Don't go long as of now because expected to see a sideways to downward momentum in Nifty in the coming week. Yeah. Let's talk banks. So banks, like we discussed last week, this was the structure which I said this is not a bullish structure. This is a very corrective structure. What looks like forming is, a flat formation, a complex flat formation. Okay, wherein now. And see, it also coincided with the news from the government of setting up, a bad bank. That news was already known. Everyone expected it. It came yesterday and the banks went up. Today we saw a bit of fall and now expecting Bank Nifty to come down to 30,300 to 34,400 levels. That is the expectation on Bank Nifty. Okay. Obviously, for that to happen, it needs to break first 34,000 levels. Okay. So first target on Bank Nifty will be 34,000, then below that it will be 30,400. I'm very bearish on banks. Yeah, if you look at the charts, you don't see a lot of bearishness as of now, but you can clearly see there is a divergence in RSI, big divergence, not just very small divergence, a big divergence on RSI, which also indicates that this particular up move didn't carry any kind of strength. A problem with divergences is divergence can continue for significant amount of time before actually there is a down move. Okay, so in Bank Nifty for traders, the view will be don't take positional longs. Okay, if someday Bank Nifty is strong, trade, but take intraday trades. Positional long trades avoid. Positionally, yes, you can take short position, but keep stop losses at the nearest highs. Okay, because these divergences can keep on continuing for some time before it actually falls. Okay, also the closing today happened at the end at the highs, which also shows some kind of strength. Okay, while on the RSI front on daily chart, if you see, there is no divergence. Okay, so though the long term view remains on banks to be weaker, they might still perk up in the short term. Okay, so avoid positional longs, but yeah, intraday longs and all can be taken on, you know, on breakouts, new highs, things like that, or near the supports. Clear on this, banks guys and Nifty? Any queries? Anyone? So this will be the trend line I will be looking at on bands. If this one breaks, okay, then this would be the support. If this breaks, then this. So these are the three supports I'll be looking, okay, on bands. And since we have considerable three kind of supports, the downside movement cannot be that fast and furious. It will be a rather slow and time-taking process. Yeah, but the view is don't go long on bands. Okay, don't be long on bands. Okay. Any questions, guys? Anyone? Any queries?
So don't be long till Bank Nifty reaches what level?
See, I show you one thing, interesting thing. If you see Elliott waves formation, this is 1, 2. Okay. 1, 2, this hole is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 3. This hole is 4. Okay. And then this will be 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 as completed. Okay. And that's why I'm expecting now a short on bands. Because after hole of this, there has to be a short, and this short can be a three-way move, 1, 2, 3. Now, like we discussed last time, where this short stops, that will tell us the ferocity of the next up move. And that's what I was mentioning. We will be then, in the, after one more fall is what we will be looking to buy for a target of 40,000. So let that one fall come, and then we'll go long on banks for target of 40,000. But as of now, let's be cautious. Let's see what happens. But mostly my view is bearish, but yeah, and then at the end of the day, these are markets. Let's see where it goes. Yeah. Clear, guys? Any questions? Someone was asking some level. Who was that? What level? I missed out, actually.
Yeah,
sorry.
Sir.
Yeah, tell me.
So you said after 38,200, if it closes above that, then we'll look to buy.
Then nothing like that. Like I mentioned, see this divergence. If you see a longer term chart, you can still see divergence on the daily chart also. Problem is these divergences don't result in a change of direction immediately. They just indicate that the trend is weakening. Okay. So it might very well happen that, you know, Bank Nifty keeps on going up, you know, in this pattern until 40,000 also. That can also happen. Okay. For example, I'll show you in Elliott terms, if you see, Bank Nifty can go to 41,200. Okay. Because in a flat formation, this high can go up to 141.4%. So bank Nifty can actually keep on going up until 41,200, and after that it might fall. That's totally possible. Okay, but then it can also fall from here, it can also fall from here, right? So the point that I'm trying to tell you guys here, don't take positional longs. Intraday, if the strength is bullish, like I took a long trade yesterday, I bought call option, I made money. Okay, but my view positionally is not long. Okay, now since this is a corrective wave, that is also one of the reason why I shorted out of money call options instead of, you know, buying put option. I could have bought put options, but the problem is in buying put options is that I'll be bearing losses if this move still continues to go up or stay sideways, and corrective waves tend to spend a lot of time. Okay, so the lot of time correction can also happen. That is the reason I chose to, you know, sell out of money options, hedge them instead of, you know, buying put options. The point I'm trying to tell is not that go ahead and take a short position. The point I'm trying to tell you guys is don't get stuck on the highs. Say in intraday, many people, you go long and end of the day you are in loss. Don't think about kya acha chalo theek hai kal tak chhod dete hain, kal upar chala jayega to nikal jayenge. No, don't do that mistake, because it might happen that you remain get stuck and market keeps on falling down. So that's the message. Now how up it can go? It can go up to 41,200. That's the thing. But yeah, let's see, next week also we'll have some more idea. Clear now?
Yes, sir. Clear. And sir, with dollar index climbing up, like we expect the next
that
candle
will be a
to
different
be
thing. I don't think dollar index will go up. If happens, we'll discuss it then and there. Okay.
Okay.
Now, Nifty ho gaya, bank Nifty ho gaya. Reality dekh lete hain. Again, see the close in reality index is bearish in the sense it has witnessed selling at the top, right? So, and this is a trend line. So if you follow the trend line, you see it's bullish in nature, but continuous selling at the top from past 2 weeks gives you an indication that the index is quite weak at this point of time. Okay, so now where will we buy? Will you buy or sell for sale? That is the question. First of all, no point selling since it's already above the, still above the trend line. So obviously it is bullish, so we'll not sell. Then should we buy? No, we cannot buy also. Why we cannot buy? Because we have continuously seen selling at these levels. So where to buy? Where to buy? Either it comes here near the trend line, shows your recovery, that's when you buy. That is one way to buy. Second is there is one candle which closes above these levels and then you buy. So in reality also the index looks weak, continuous selling at the highs, but as of now neither you will buy nor you will sell. You will buy only if you see a new high coming, okay, or you will see a recovery from the trend line. So either in those cases you will look to buy. If the trend line breaks, then we'll see then what, how is the patterns and what is the outlook on the markets, and we'll decide whether to short or not. Okay, that would be the view on reality. Any questions, anyone? And this would be something, you know, very similar. You will find almost every index this week. Okay, because next week the outlook is bearish, so most of the indices would be showing you selling at the top. Same is with pharma. Pharma, last week we discussed unless and until it makes a new high, it still remains bearish and still it is below the previous swing high. So again, in pharma also the outlook remains neutral. Okay, no buying, no selling. Okay, when to buy? So this week will be like this. When to buy? Only if we see pharma breaking above the past swing high, that's when we'll look to buy. Now individual stocks might be a different story, so we'll discuss all of them. But on index, the index still looks in sideways momentum, doesn't show any kind of bullish nature. At the same time, there is no bearishness also, we can say, because it is clearly, when we went long here. Okay, so people who are holding pharma should also exit. So we went long here. This was its demand zone from where it went up. Now it's stuck in a sideways range. Okay, so unless and until it breaks out on the either side of this range, we cannot think about buying or selling. The best thing to do will be to buy here, sell here, buy here, sell here. Okay, or you buy or sell on the breakouts, breakdowns. Okay. Metals again. Again, this is, three wave structure, 1, 2, 3, X, 1, 2, and then 3. So if you see in metals also, the structure forming is a bearish one. Okay. So again, metals also, the expectation is this week will be weak. Okay. So this is how the structure in metal is forming. A, B, C. This is X wave. A, B has formed. Now expecting a C wave to form. So again, in metals, the outlook looks bleak and I'm expecting a fall in metals, a correction in metals. Good correction, actually. Heavy correction we can see in the coming week in metals. Okay, something like the correction that happened, almost 4 weeks back. So something like a candle like this is what I'm expecting. And then they will give us a good opportunity to again enter in. But as of now, again, metals are a complete sell. Okay, it's not a buy at all. Okay, and we'll see each of the metal stocks to see where we can sell something. Okay, if you find something selling, worth selling, we'll do that. Nifty Media broke out, but see where it closed. It closed right at its previous high. Okay, not even a bit higher. What does it show again? This whole move was a trading move. Now, एक चीज समझो आप लोग, कोई भी स्टॉक है वो बढ़ता तब रहता है जब पीपल कंटिन्यू पुटिंग मनी इन इट. ओके, एंड उसमें होता क्या, एक इन्वेस्टर यहाँ आया, ठीक है, फिर एक इन्वेस्टर यहाँ आया, ठीक है, फिर एक इन्वेस्टर यहाँ आया, तो ये बढ़ता रहता है. ठीक है, हायर हाई हायर लो का कंसेप्ट क्या होता है कि ये हायर लो क्यों बनता है, क्योंकि यहाँ पे जब सेलिंग होती है, so these are small time frame traders, matlab ki swing traders, people like who trade, cause of them this dip comes. Then people who invest, they come in again, take the price higher again, traders book their profit, short term traders, again it falls, then again investors come, they take the price up. Okay, that's why this higher high concept comes from, that is the psychology. Okay, now here a dip like this means what? All the people who bought it, they exited, they booked out their profit. That's why the index has fallen down, right? And this fall, if you see, is coinciding with its supply zone. This was the supply zone on this index and it has closed below this, which again is not a very good closing. So now the problem is you cannot sell it here because the candle is strong. So you will need to wait for further signals. So say Monday, you start seeing, a gap up failing. Okay, or you start seeing a gap down, that means this index has again started the downtrend, and then you can look at something like these levels. You can make this trend line and you can expect it to hit minimum this trend line. So on media stocks also, the media stock that you guys are, if anyone is carrying, okay, look to exit them. Okay, don't keep them, only we will hold them if the index starts, giving a close above its supply zone. So as of now, media stocks also, if you guys are holding, look to exit it, book profits, because they don't look strong. Okay. Chalo, IT. IT is one index which actually did wonders. We expected last week that IT might be showing a little bit of consolidation. Nothing like that it showed. Instead of that, it has given a new high this week. Okay, many of the stocks also have popped up. Now, anyone can tell why this has happened? Can anyone? I explained last week why this also can happen, though we thought that this possibility is less, but there. Anyone?
The dollar index taking support?
Yeah, dollar is the reason. Because see, with IT, like last time we discussed, IT के साथ क्या है कि इट्स अ ग्लोबल फेसिंग business. It is more export oriented. So if dollar goes up, okay, the moment dollar goes up, IT also goes up. Okay, because वैल्यू बढ़ जाती है इन टर्म्स ऑफ व्हाट दे आर एक्सपोर्टिंग. जो आज वो चीज 1 डॉलर की बेच रहे थे जिसकी वैल्यू से 70 रुपये होगी, क्योंकि डॉलर बढ़ गया, वो 1 डॉलर की वैल्यू 75 होगा. बिकॉज दीज गाइज आर गेटिंग पेड इन डॉलर, दे आर नॉट गेटिंग पेड इन रुपी. ओके, सो व्हाट वर्क फॉर आईटी दिस वीक वॉज डॉलर इंडेक्स. ओके, सिंस डॉलर स्ट्रेंथन, दो वी एक्सपेक्टेड द दैट यू नो ड्यू टू सेक्टर रोटेशन सम मनी विल मूव आउट ऑफ आईटी एंड विल मूव इन यू नो बैंकिंग फाइनेंशियल्स फॉर ए स्मॉल बिट ऑफ अप. एक्चुअली आईटी आल्सो स्टार्टेड मूविंग ऑन. सो व्हिच वाज द सेक्टर व्हिच सैक्रिफाइज दिस वीक वाज मोस्टली एफएमसीजी. दैट वाज द सेक्टर व्हिच सैक्रिफाइज एंड फार्मा एंड रियलिटी. दीज वर द 3 सेक्टर्स व्हिच वर एक्चुअली मोर बुलिश, बट दीज आर द 3 सेक्टर्स व्हिच सैक्रिफाइज फॉर आईटी टू मूव अप. एंड the reason is very clear. Dollar moving up is not good for domestic economy, and that's why FMCG, realty, all these sectors which are totally completely facing the economy, domestic economy, they didn't work too well. They started good in start of the week, but slowly they tapered down. Okay, so again, since the view on dollar is still it might go a bit up, IT might be one sector which we can expect to do good again continuously in next week. Okay. The only thing is you will see certain headwinds because Nifty and Bank Nifty might show a little bit of weakness. So the idea will be to buy IT stocks when they come near their supports and not to right away enter them at their tops. Okay. If you buy them near their supports, you'll definitely make money. So that would be the idea. Clear guys on the IT?
Yes.
So see, this was the FMCG sector. So like I said, we were very bullish on this. It did good first 2 days. Monday, Tuesday was very good for FMCG, but then Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, since 3 days, this sector didn't do much. Okay, and that's the sector. That's the time it coincided with the up move in IT. So this time IT mein upar ja raha tha, these were the sectors which were coming down, and that coincided with dollar movement. Dollar didn't do that good in on Monday, Tuesday, and that's why these sectors started doing good. But then dollar strengthened in midweek, and these sectors started dropping off. So again, if dollar continues to strengthen a bit, okay, which is the expectation, FMCG would be the sector which might show you a little bit more weakness. Okay, though that doesn't mean it has become bearish. That would just mean a small pause in the long-term bull market. And we will use that to, get in again, get long on many other stocks which you would have missed in past. Okay. So FMCG again for next week. Be cautious. Okay, don't get stuck on the long. Okay. Finance very similar to Bank Nifty and very similar view to banks. Okay. Can continue moving up, but there is no strength in this up move. This whole up move is a corrective wave. This is a complex B wave of a long-term correction that is setting in. Okay, and this should definitely be followed by a strong downtrend. Now, when that downtrend occurs, that is something which cannot be told looking at the chart. Okay, but what we can do is we can stay away from getting stuck at the highs and stay put. We will get long once this trend line is broken. Get short, sorry. Okay, so again on IT, again on finance, the idea will be don't look at getting longs. Most of the breakouts you will see will act as trap. Avoid getting stuck in them. Okay, the structure is bearish in nature. This whole formation is bearish in nature. It's not a bullish formation whatsoever. Okay, and so we can expect pretty soon, a down move to start. That down move, once it's triggered by, the break of this trend line, we will look to short it then. Okay, because that will give us good 30-40% return in each stock. One stock we can make 2 lakh to 3 lakh rupees profit. So let's wait for that big move to come. Until then, avoid getting stuck at the highs. Auto was the sector of the week, as discussed last time. This was our sector, one of the sectors which did fantastically well, a lot of money being made. Still, the outlook looks bullish in auto. Okay, the only issue being again in auto is that it will also obviously be impacted by headwinds on Nifty and Bank Nifty. It is very, again, a very domestically facing sector, and a strength in dollar will be, you know, something bad for the sector. So in coming week, we might see auto stocks again doing a bit bad. Okay, but that will only act as an opportunity to go long, just like it was last week. You know, last week you went long, you made a lot of money. Again, next week we might see a little bit of downside on auto stocks, but again, that will be an opportunity to go long, unless and until this is the trend line that it breaks, which I don't think. Now you guys might be thinking these trend lines are so small, but these are on weekly chart. Okay, if you just make it on a daily chart, you see a significant time. Okay, so these jab tak auto sector is trend line ke upar hai, tab tak rest assured, the moment starts breaking, then it starts becoming an issue. Okay, but what my idea is, we might see a fall near this trend line. Okay, and this is the trend line where we should start looking for opportunity for reversals and again going long. Okay, so that would be the idea. Other would be, you know, and if auto's tech index starts closing over 10,400, 10,400, again, that would also be one thing where we should be looking to go long. So we'll see next week what's happening. Clear, guys, on all sectors? Any questions on any of the sector? Anyone, any query? चलो अभी काम करते हैं, 5:41 हो रहा है, 10 मिनट मुझे दो, 5:51 पे मिलते हैं, ठीक है, 5:51, 5:52 पे, जस्ट गिव मी 10 मिनट्स, लेट मी हैव सम थिंग टू ड्रिंक, ओके गाइस, कूल विथ यू ऑल,
यस,
या, लेट्स टेक 10 मिनट्स ब्रेक, देन वी स्टार्ट अगेन, ओके, एंड वी गो ऑन टू द स्टॉक्स. Hello guys, can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
Let's begin with the stocks now. Yeah. Let's start with IT. I think IT should be the only sector. Rest all sectors are a bit dicey. The IT is something which we can look for some opportunities and next week clear cut. Okay. Wipro. Yeah, so Wipro C looks good near its trend line. Okay, this again C looks like a flat formation, or it can be 1-2, both it can be whatever it is. But in both cases, the next move should be upwards. So Wipro should be one thing which can be bought with a stop of 655. Okay, this is one stock which can be bought. So Monday, look for Wipro as closer as you can buy to 655. Look to buy near as close as to 655. Target will be 680 to what was the recent high? 690. So 680 to 690. The good risk reward trade is there. Okay, so this is one thing which you guys should buy. Tech Mahindra, sideways movement. Coming week, wait for it to close above. This side will one, let it give a breakout, okay, before buying. Okay, so how to take trade in Tech Mahindra? One is to, since it is sideways movement, either it gives a breakout, then you will buy, or again, since you know the index looks bullish, if it comes near this lower level of the sideways movement around 1410, 1412, that's also would be a place to buy. So, two ways to buy Tech Mahindra: either it gives you a breakout, okay, above this range, then you buy, or it comes near the lower end of the range near 1410, 11, 12, then you buy. Okay, made my bad buy karna. TCS again, see this again. Either it can be this hole can be a flat formation 1, 2, 3, okay, which is completed and should go up, or it can be a 1, 2. If it is 1, 2, then it almost has already completed its correction. Okay, so on TCS still you cannot directly straight away say that you know this is a buy. Okay, so wait for my instructions on TCS. If there will be a buy midweek, I'll anyway update you guys. As of now I think Wipro and Tech Mahindra are a better structure in terms of, you know, better places where you can enter with more clarity. TCS also, this short-term trend line it is following, so let's see on Monday. Okay, let's see on Monday how it is behaving, and accordingly we'll take the trade. Oracle Finance is stuck in a sideways zone. Okay, so again on Oracle also the strategy will be very simple: let it close above this zone. So this whole zone is a sideways zone. We'll buy only if it is closes above the upper range, or we'll sell if it closes below. Okay, but yeah, definitely still bullish in nature. Okay, and if honest, this one looks like a pennant pattern. Okay, flag and pennant pattern, upward movement, then sideways movement, and again a consolidation after that, a upward movement. So that's how it looks like. So again, this should also continue moving higher. This is again something which you guys can look to buy somewhere closer to 4686, 4690. That is the level where you can look to buy it, okay, for a levels closer to 4900 to 5000. Okay, Emphasis, good chart, clear cut chart, very clear cut bullish pattern, very clear cut bullish pattern, flag and pole pattern. Okay, this is the flag happening, this pole. Now this flag usually forms in 3 to 5. Okay, two is formed at max, one more, and then that will be. So again, in this case, यू शुड लुक टू बाई दिस पर्टिकुलर स्टॉक एट अराउंड 31-30 के आसपास, जितना क्लोजर 31-30 वुड बी बेटर सेल, नियर दैट 31-30 यू शुड बाई एंड यू कैन कीप अ गुड टारगेट ऑफ 3300 ऑन दिस। माइंडट्री अपवर्ड मूवमेंट कंसोलिडेशन कल बहुत अच्छा मूव आया था माइंडट्री में, कल पैसे बने थे। ओके राइट नाउ लुक्स लाइक स्टक इन अ साइडवेज मूवमेंट, सो अगेन ऑन माइंडट्री द आइडिया विल बी टू buy only on breakouts. Okay, the good thing about knowing the sectoral view is that you will know which breakouts will fail and which breakouts may sustain. Since IT looks positive strong, a breakout in IT stocks will have higher chances of being a start of a new up move, a strong up move, rather than a breakout in finance or banks where a breakout can turn out to be a fake out. So keep that in mind. लार्सन, ये भी काफी अच्छे थे, ये तो हम ऑलरेडी बुलिश भी थे लास्ट वीक, स्टिल लुकिंग गुड। 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, दिस इज द फिफ्थ वेव ऑफ दिस थर्ड वेव, इट इज फॉर्मिंग। Fifth wave of third wave is forming. Okay, so let's see where we can go from here. So guys, this is where you look to buy again. So LDI will be something which you will look to buy near this particular trend line. Okay. तो गाइस एंट्री में क्या लगता है, एनीवन एनी व्यूज? एनी आइडिया? एंट्री गाइस देखो, ये भी स्टिल कंसोलिडेटिंग, इट हैज नॉट गिवन यू अ ब्रेकआउट। ये अगर कैंडल जहां तक ऊपर तक गया था वहां क्लोज हो जाता, देन चांसेस ऑफ ब्रेकआउट नेक्स्ट वीक वुड हैव बीन हायर। सो अगेन कीप इट ऑन अ वॉच लिस्ट, ओके? ओनली वंस इट क्लोजेस अबाउट दिस पर्टिकुलर ट्रेंड लाइन वी विल लुक टू बाय, ओके? बट एज ऑफ नाउ स्टिल स्टक इन अ साइडवेज मूवमेंट। टेक गुड वीकली क्लोजिंग, डेली चार्ट इज ऑल्सो लुकिंग गुड। दिस वन अगेन गाइस, दिस वुड बिगिन यू विल बाय नियर द ट्रेंड लाइन, एज सिंपल एज दैट। ओके सेम विद कोफोर्स, कोफोर्स का चार्ट जो है नॉट वेरी कन्विंसिंग, अवॉइड इट। ओके वीकली पे तो अच्छा दिख रहा है, वॉल्यूम सपोर्ट नहीं है, डाइवर्जेंस है, दैट्स व्हाई अवॉइड इट। ओके डोंट लुक टू गो लॉन्ग इन दिस पर्टिकुलर, ओके? दिस डजंट लुक दैट कन्विंसिंग। ओके नीदर द वॉल्यूम इज गुड, देयर इज अ डाइवर्जेंस एट द टॉप, ओके? सो अवॉइड दिस वन, दो इट लुक्स वेरी गुड on if you just remove the volume in this, it looks very good strong bullish structure, okay? But cause of this, try to avoid any kind of a positional long on Cofers. क्लियर गाइस ऑन आईटी स्टॉक्स? एनीवन एनी क्वेश्चंस ऑन एनी ऑफ देम? आज थोड़ा मैं जल्दी जल्दी भाग रहा हूँ बिकॉज आई हैव अ लॉट ऑफ वर्क. एनी क्वेरीज गाइस? चलो फर्स्ट लेट्स. या चलो मेटल्स देख लेते हैं. निफ्टी मेटल वेल स्पन. आई बी बेट फास्ट गाइस. अगर जिसमें किसी में ट्रेड नहीं होगा आई वॉन्ट एक्सप्लेन मच. वेल स्पन में कुछ नहीं है. वेदांता नथिंग. एक्सक्यूज मी फॉर दिस वीक नॉट टू बी सो डिटेल्ड. टाटा स्टील ऑल्सो नथिंग एज ऑफ नाउ. स्टील नथिंग. Ratan Money, you guys should keep on watch list. Okay, this looks like something which might give you a midweek breakout in next week. Okay, just keep a trigger. 22-26 ka maine lagaya hai. NMDC, nothing. National Aluminium, nothing. Oil mein kuch nahi hai. JSW Steel mein bhi nothing. Jindal, Hind Junk, Hindalco, Hindalco to kuch nahi ho raha hai, Coal India, ye le ye shuru ho gaya, yehi sabse zyada bhaga hai. So guys, dekho metals mein, like I said, view was bearish. Okay, expecting big drop, like I said, पहले ये जैसा ऐसा ही कुछ कैंडल दिखने को मिलेगा. That's what my expectation is, and that's what the chart of each of this, you know, metal stocks are showing. इसको देख लो. Looks like it will go down from here. ठीक है, this is how it looks like. This is the trend line. Vedanta देख लो. Again, lower top, lower bottom. लग रहा है बनने वाला है. Tata Steel. Same thing near the top. Again, it gave away all the gains the moment it reached top. Sale same. देखो sale इतने दिनों से इस level के नीचे नहीं जा रहा था. अभी closing दे दिया है. ठीक है. So again we Ratan Money is looking the only stock which is good. So सब गिरेंगे तो कहीं ना कहीं तो पैसा जाएगा. So this is one thing keep at your radar. Okay, must keep this on your radar. This might give you a very good upside momentum while every other metal stock falls. So keep this on your radar. NMDC already started. Okay, clear cut downtrend में है. National Aluminium बोला ही था, profit book कर लिया था, निकल गए उसके बाद से देखो. और इसमें भी मैंने जैसे क्या बोला था कि अगर इस continues going down, it will reach to level of this 68-69 and will be the target. Moil clear cut downtrend, this will be the trend line. JSW Steel same. Okay, Jindal. You can clearly see message is very clear. Engine doesn't look weak, but this structure is not bullish structure. This is a corrective structure, and that's why again the view on this also will be negative. Hindalco very similar to Tata Steel, gave up all the gains near the top. Coal India did good, but where is it closing? Near its supply zone. This is the supply zone below which it has closed. APL clear cut now, मतलब इसमें तो कुछ है ही नहीं, दिमाग ही नहीं लगाना है.
अच्छा, तो APL अपोलो में स्प्लिट, ये 1:1 का बोनस है.
हाँ पता है,
ये इसलिए 50% डाउन दिख रहा है.
नहीं नहीं 50%
अदरवाइज अपवर्ड है, ये अपवर्ड ही दिख रहा है ये.
हाँ नहीं नहीं ये 50% डाउन उसकी वजह से
ये कल रहा है. कल
बट इसमें काफी प्रॉफिट बुकिंग भी हुई है. यू सी द वॉल्यूम, आई एम नॉट ओनली टॉकिंग अबाउट दिस, सी द वॉल्यूम.
कल इसकी रिकॉर्ड डेट थी और 18 को ये इस पे वो देना है 1:1 का बोनस.
यस, ये हाफ हो जाएगा पूरा.
हां हाफ ही हो गया ना, 1700 से 1800 से 940 पे आया ना. कल बल्कि वो अप था ये 3%.
एंड सेम केस वेदांता में, वेदांता ने ऑलरेडी दे दिया है. वेदांता में बोनस इशू नहीं हो रहा, बट डिविडेंड ऑलरेडी इशू हो गया.
डिविडेंड अच्छा है वेदांता में, डिविडेंड अच्छा
है, बहुत अच्छा है इस बार. यस
या आई एम होल्डिंग बोथ. I am holding in the portfolio.
Yeah, Vedanta, I got 66,000 almost. आज ही credit हुआ है ना?
हाँ, आज credit हुआ.
आज ही हुआ है. तो अब यही, तो metal stocks में actually for investors, if you see ना, अभी उतना कुछ है नहीं बचा हुआ. That's why all these stocks, you know, they are now looking, you know, 2, 3, 4, 5% upper niche, and that's the trend that will continue next week. Okay. So again, these stocks are weak, so don't indulge into them, don't buy them. नीचे आते हैं, ऑटो देख लेते हैं. ऑटो वाज वन सेक्टर व्हिच डिड गुड, अगेन लुकिंग लाइक विल डू गुड फॉर दिस वीक. सो टीवीएस में लाइक आई सेड गाइस, दिस अगर ये 555 के ऊपर, आज कॉल में बोला ही था, उसके ऊपर क्लोजिंग ना दे, देन जस्ट एग्जिट इट और एटलीस्ट ट्रेड योर कॉस्ट बिकॉज़ ऑफ दिस रीजन, कि हो सकता है वापस से फिर नीचे आ जाए, यू नो, एंड मेक्स अ न्यू लो. व्हाई टेक दैट रिस्क, यू नो? सो दैट वाज द रीजन. आई होप यू ऑल वुड हैव एग्जिटेड दोस हु हैड बॉट इट. New investment is looking good. Okay, so last week only we said we will look to buy new investments once it makes a new high. If you would have bought, you would have either made profit or you would have exited at no cost, no profit. Up to you how you trade it. Tata Motors continuously is going up. Was a buy call. Looks good. Still is good. And सबने पैसे दिए हैं. M&M and all almost पैसे इस week. सबने दिए हैं. जिन लोगों ने बस ट्रेल नहीं किया होगा उनका अभी लॉस होगा या निकल गए होंगे, बट पीपल हु वुड हैव ट्रेल्ड इधर दे वुड हैव बुक प्रॉफिट और दे वुड हैव मेड यू नो 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 प्रॉफिट नो लॉस. सो एंड ऑल ऑफ दीज ऑटो स्टॉक्स आर लुकिंग गुड, ऑल ऑफ देम आर लुकिंग गुड, ऑल मेड गुड मनी दिस वीक, ऑलमोस्ट ऑल ऑफ देम. एंड स्टिल इफ यू सी इन द कमिंग वीक ऑल्सो दे विल कंटिन्यू टू डू सो. कमिंग वीक में बस टीवीएस में जस्ट don't focus. TVS will be a buy again only if it closes above this particular trend line. This will again be a buy again it closes above this particular resistance level of 1450. Ab iske upar hi hai, so this is already a buy. Tata Motors keep holding, trail keep trailing your stops, looks very good. M&M wait for some time. Okay, like mentioned last time, will buy only if it closes above this particular trend line. MRF was a buy call actually. Okay, did good first 2 days, 3 days. After that, it has come down. Again, I mean, this is very similar to all other auto stocks, you know. So again, we'll buy it only if it closes above this particular trend line. Maruti was a buy, made good money, still looks good. But yeah, coming week, be cautious because if Nifty Bank, Nifty don't do good, you know, the broader market is looking weak. If broader market don't do good, then all of these stocks will also not do good. What does it mean that you should look to buy or enter these stocks since they are strong, but where near their supports? Don't go and buy Monday ko gap down hua, ye nahi ki auto stocks khareed lo. Monday ko gap down hua, wait karo, dekho auto stocks ko, they are bullish, so idea clear hai ki buy karna hai. Kab karna hai? Near their supports. Okay, so Maruti is also looking good. You can look to buy it somewhere around 68-50 levels if you get it. Hero Motor looks very good. Okay, this again you can look to buy it somewhere around 2800 if you get it. Okay, Exide again was a buy call, looks really good. Keep holding it, guys. This will give you really good money. Okay, ये clear cut consolidation is trend line पे कर रहा है. ठीक है, already it has given you good money this week. 4-5 बार इसका lot size भी बढ़ा है. ठीक है, around 30-40,000 almost profit है. Excitement, keep holding it. The moment it goes above 200 now, it will go ballistic. It will go to 220 in like no time. 200 तक जाने में जितना time लगना है लगे, 200 पे अगर closing आ गई, 220-250 ऐसे ही आ जाएगा. So keep holding it. ठीक है, iShares is also good. iShares में the only problem I have is again this structure is not very bullish in nature. That's why I did not give a call last week. It did good, but I have not given the call in it. This week again, I will not give you any call to buy in iShares. Let it run. It might run still a bit, but the structure is not to my liking, and that's the reason not giving any calls in this. Bosch also did good. Okay, very similar to all the so same thing, same story. Nothing else. It closed above the trend line. That's why we gave a buy call. It went up. Still looks good, but yeah, just remember, it is very near the target. So. People who are already long, keep holding. People who are not long, don't enter now. Last week only we went long on this. People who are not long, wait for it to come down, then only go long. So if you get it somewhere around 14,250, 14,300, then you enter, else leave it. Mostly you will not get it. Okay. Bharat Forge we discuss only will buy if it goes above this particular trigger point, which was 829.30. So let it go above that first, then we discuss Bal Krishna. Midweek ne isme breakout bhi diya tha, but then again it came down. Okay, again the same call continues. We'll buy only if it goes above 2500 levels. If it is closing, then we'll look to buy. As of now, leave it as of now. Okay, Bajaj Auto, very similar. Okay, people who want, this is one stock which people can re-enter tomorrow itself. Okay, you can keep a stop of somewhere around 35-50 levels and you can go long on Bajaj Auto. Ashok Leyland, again something which will go up, but just like Aisha, this stock structure is not bullish. Okay, so I will be interested in buying this only once it breaks my trigger of 140. Only above that I look to buy. Amara Raja also did good. Okay, again this is one stock which is you can buy next week, you know, and keep a small stop loss of last week's low of, you know, somewhere around 710-11 and expect a good target of, you know, 800 to 850 rupees. Okay. Clear guys on auto stocks mein kya karna, any questions kisi mein hai to pooch lo. Auto stocks mein yaad rakho, nayi entries अभी आपको मारुति में मिल सकता है, हीरो में मिल सकता है, एक्साइड में भी शायद मिल जाए. लुक फॉर न्यू एंट्रीज, पीपल हु आर ऑलरेडी लॉन्ग बी लॉन्ग. टीवीएस इज द ओनली स्टॉक व्हिच वी रिकमेंडेड इन ऑटो लास्ट वीक, जो हमने एग्जिट दे दिया है ऑलरेडी बिकॉज इट डिडंट सस्टेन. ओके,
बजाज एक भाई,
बजाज बजाज इज गुड, बजाज इज गुड.
सो इज दैट द फ्लैट फॉर्मेशन व्हिच क्लोजेस
It is something like a flat formation which is closing open. That's why I'm saying it is good. It can give you a very good up move and very fast and swift up move. So this is something which you should look to buy. Yeah. Okay. Banks pe aate hain. Banks mein guys, structure is not bullish. Discuss kar chuke hain. Same structure har jagah dikhega. Okay. एस बी आई एन हो गया, आर बी एल हो गया, जो भी ये सारे स्टॉक्स हैं हम सबको एग्जिट करने का टाइम आ गया है. ओके, सो कीप ट्रेलिंग देम. ओके, विल नॉट एग्जिट एज लाइक यू नो फटाक से, कीप ट्रेलिंग देम. स्टॉप लॉस जब जैसे ही आपका ट्रेलिंग ऐसे लेट होता है निकल जाओ, सिंपल सा फंडा है. ठीक है, नई एंट्री प्रोहिबिटेड. डोंट एंटर एनी थिंग न्यू ऑन ए पोजिशनल बेसिस ऑन एनी ऑफ दिस बैंकिंग स्टॉक्स. ओके, all of them you see SBIN upper selling, RBL selling upper, PNB massive selling, Kotak Bank looks good, this one looks good, very good actually. Okay, so Kotak is looking really good. Kotak would be something that we will have our interest on. Keep this in your watch list. Volume is also good, RSI is also good. Total buy. Yeah, this is something which is totally a buy. Okay. Now again, if whole market falls, crashes, then this should be an opportunity. One stock, which will be an opportunity for us to get into long in banking space, would be Kotak. Okay. It is looking really good. We'll get long on this once we get an opportunity. Okay. So whenever it comes some near any office, अब देखो इसमें problem क्या है? It is near its all-time highs. Yeah, you see, Kotak is near its all-time highs. The problem यहाँ long होने में तुरंत क्या है कि अगर आप long हुए कल को ये ऊपर गया वापस गिर गया तो again it will be a massive fall and you'll lose a lot of money. So what will be the right thing to do will be wait for it to either give you a breakout close above this recent highs and then you go long, or if it falls and gives you know you look to go long somewhere around 1910, 1900, something like that. Okay, with a small stop loss of 5-10 points. So these are the only two ways you can go long in Kotak. Right now looks very good. Okay, but risk reward is not favorable. Okay, and that's why you don't buy it immediately on opening. Wait, look to buy 5 मिनट कैंडल, 10 मिनट, 15 मिनट आपका इसके ऊपर क्लोज होता है, देन लुक टू बाय, कीप ए स्मॉल स्टॉप जस्ट बिफोर दिस लाइन, देन ओके, इफ इट फॉल्स डाउन देन लुक टू बाय समवेयर अराउंड 1900, ओके, सो दैट्स हाउ यू हैव टू ट्रेड इन कोटर. Indusind Bank again, structure is not bullish, okay, though it has given kind of a breakout, but since the structure is not bullish, don't go long on it. जी हर, ये अच्छी वाली नींद, अभी एक और मीटिंग है, दिमाग खराब है सर. IDFC में भी कुछ नहीं है, ICICI में भी नथिंग, ट्रेल नथिंग, बंधन, एक्सिस इन बैंक्स, ओनली कोटक इज देयर एज ऑफ नाउ वर्थ बाइंग or worth looking for an opportunity to buy. Rest all of them. Those who are long, keep trailing your stops or book out, because a big fall is ahead in most of them. Almost one, SBI definitely looks like there will be a good fall. RBL after going a little bit more up, looks like there will be a good fall. PNB already has shown its weakness. Indusind Bank again. So all of the banks, though they are showing on chart, you know, a structure which would look very bullish, if you look at the structure minutely, the structures are very deceptive in nature. Don't get trapped on the highs, wait for a big fall in them and then we go down. Not right now. Only right now, Kotak is the only bank you should look at going long safely. Okay. That too, not near its highs. Wait for it to give you a certain amount of retracement before you go high, or if there is a breakout, then that's another story. Clear, guys?
Sir?
Yeah.
So if we look at daily charts of almost all of these, it's clearly showing a breakout and then a bearish engulfing. So that confirms that people are getting trapped.
Okay, let me just
share. So I'm looking at Federal Bank, Bandhan Bank.
Yeah, if you see daily also, yeah, very true. Yeah, so see, the charts always speak really nicely. PNB, you see, all of these are, this is all showing a lot of profit booking under top. Okay. Almost all of them. Good.
So Federal showed a breakout and then engulfing, yeah. Both of these.
So all of these banks, guys, that's what I'm saying. In midweek also, if you guys see any kind of breakouts in banks, don't get so excited and go long, okay, positionally. And even if you go long, trail your stops very tightly, okay? So that if there is a reversal, you lose a small amount of money, not more. Because there will be reversal. The problem with technical analysis is technical analysis doesn't tell you time when something will happen. It only tells you, yeah, this might happen. So be prepared for that and don't be massively long on the banks. Apart from Kotak, Kotak will look to buy. Okay. Clear, everyone? So Kotak has 5% bada kyun? Koi news thi kya Kotak mein? Anyone any idea? फार्मा तो वैसे ही गिरा हुआ सेक्टर है अभी. नथिंग इन टोरेंट, नथिंग सन फार्मा, नथिंग इन लूपिन, डॉक्टर रेड्डी में कुछ नहीं है. दिवीज लुक्स गुड, हाउ गुड, नॉट दैट गुड, लुक्स ओके. ओनली थिंग गुड अबाउट दिवीज इज इफ यू वांट टू बाय, यू कैन बाय विद अ स्मॉल स्टॉप लॉस वेरी नियर इट्स trend line, so that gives you a good risk reward trade. Okay, this week, guys, I am also seeing we are not getting so much opportunity, huh? Don't have lot many opportunities to trade on this week. जस्ट लाइक लास्ट टू लास्ट वीक, लास्ट टू लास्ट वीक भी बहुत कम अपॉर्चुनिटी थी, इस वीक भी बहुत कम अपॉर्चुनिटी, तो स्टे सेफ फॉर दिस वीक. Already almost half, more than half of the month has gone. Already you guys have made good profit. Protect your profits. Some weeks are bad. In those weeks, look at protecting. Even if possible, I'll say avoid trading in these in the coming week. Okay, you'll make less wrong decisions. Supply in nothing to do. Biocon gives a good reversal, but just near its supply zone where it has stopped. That raises eyebrows. So let it. This was something which also we gave a buy last week. This was the only one of the, I guess, two or three only buy calls were there in pharma. Biocon was one of them just because it was near its trend line and gave good money. But again, now since this is near its supply zone, wait for it to close above the supply zone, then only we buy. So above 380 we'll look to buy Biocon, okay, with a small stop loss of 5.275 ke long trade liya ja sakta hai. Auro mein nothing. Apollo Hospital looks good, definitely buy. So Apollo Hospitals guys is something which you guys can look to buy. Yeah, good bounce from the trend line. Yeah, so you can buy and keep, you know, as SL of 4674. Do buy this one, looks good. 4674 ke SL ke saath isko buy kar lo. Okay, somewhere around these levels. Okay, just open an early chart to get you know a perfect.
So what will be the target?
Target will be recent high minimum 5,100.
Risk reward
is 1:1, but that is minimum target. If it goes above that, then it can go to 5,706,000. Okay, but that's your minimum target. Risk reward you will get 1:1. Alchem again, avoid it as of now, looks bearish. FMCG ने बहुत गंदा किया इस वीक, वॉज नॉट एक्सपेक्टेड, बट मेनी ऑफ द FMCG स्टॉक्स एक्चुअली डिड रियली बैड. सब ने हाई बनाया और उसके बाद गिरे हैं. सो ऑलमोस्ट सब में स्टॉप लॉसेज, ट्रेलिंग स्टॉप लॉस हिट हुए, तो पैसा ऑलमोस्ट नहीं बना है. मेरा खुद का FMCG स्टॉक्स में मेरा पैसा सिर्फ ITC में बना है, विच वॉज ए बाई लास्ट वीक. ओके, अपार्ट फ्रॉम दैट जितने भी FMCG स्टॉक्स थे मेरे, सब में से मेरा एग्जिट हो चुका है ऑलरेडी. Okay, because सब में मेरा ट्रेलिंग ऐसे लेट हुआ, तो ये चाहे वो वरुण हो, चाहे वो UBL हो, टाटा कंज्यूमर, प्रॉक्टर, नेस्ले, मैकडॉवेल, मारिको, जुबिलेंट, सब में सिर्फ ITC ने पैसा बनाया. दिस वॉज अ बाई कॉल, गिव गुड मनी. सो ऑन कमिंग वीक व्हाट इज द व्यू गाइस ऑन FMCG, एनीवन?
Sir, if dollar index goes up, so domestic market should be affected. So FMCG again sideways.
But see, one very important thing I'll tell you guys. Dollar going up will impact domestic market, but mainly it will impact banks and financial. That's the place where the impact is most. अब अगर banks और financials पे impact बहुत ज़्यादा हो रहा है and उनसे बहुत ज़्यादा पैसा निकल रहा है, ठीक है? So, बाकी सेक्टर से उतना पैसा नहीं निकलेगा. कहने का मतलब ये है कि इफ बैंक्स डू गुड, रिलेटिवली गुड, देन FMCG विल डू रियली बैड इन द कमिंग. इफ बैंक्स डू वेरी पुअर, देन FMCG एंड मेटल्स विल नॉट डू दैट बैड. दे विल स्टिल फॉल बट नॉट दैट मच. ओके, also one more observation that you will see that many of these stocks are very closer to their trend line and they are already in uptrend. So this coming week we might see many of the FMCG stocks giving a buy and then midweek. Okay, so idea should be to keep looking for buying opportunities in these stocks in coming weeks. So midweek may we can get a lot of buy. Marico is also very near to its trend line. Okay. अभी फिलहाल कोई नया बाई तो मुझे नहीं दिख रहा है अपार्ट फ्रॉम डाबर. हाँ वही डाबर में ही है बस. डाबर वाज बाई कॉल एनीवे लास्ट वीक. मैंने बोला था खरीदना है खरीद लो ठीक है. जस्ट एंड देखो लास्ट वीक बोला था ना देखो ये पैटर्न फॉलो कर रहा है बुलिश बेरिश बुलिश बेरिश बुलिश. सो दिस वीक अगेन इट माइट शो अ लिटिल बिट ऑफ बेरिशनेस दैट माइट बी अ केस के ऊपर जाए फिर नीचे आए. तो डाबर खरीदना है तो खरीद लो लेकिन फिर वही डाउन जब नीचे आया यू अगेन लुक टू बाय समवेयर नियर क्लोजर टू 636 एंड ऑल. डोंट गेट ट्रैप्ड ऑन द हाइज. ओके व्हेनेवर मार्केट में बेयरिशनेस हो डोंट गेट ट्रैप्ड एट द हाइज. एंड अभी मार्केट में मोस्ट ऑफ द थिंग्स आर हाई सो ओनली लुक टू बाय स्ट्रांग स्टॉक्स नियर देयर सपोर्ट. एफएमसीजी इज स्ट्रांग सेक्टर स्टॉक्स आर स्ट्रांग. ओके Britannia structure is very similar to Bank Nifty structure. So if it falls, it will fall badly. Okay, if it falls, it will fall to 3400 levels. Okay, so be careful. There is no clear cut buy on anyone apart from ITC, which we are already down. Apart from that, none of the FMCG stocks are showing a clear cut buy as of now. ज़ील इतनी मांग हुई है बताओ. ज़ील में मैंने लास्ट वीक बोला था कि इसको क्लोज होने दो इस लाइन के ऊपर तब बात करेंगे. कुछ ज्यादा ही ऊपर क्लोज हो गया राइट. सो अभी छोड़ दो अभी ये भी खरीदने लायक नहीं है. अभी ये भी ऊपर से काफी सेलिंग 300 लेवल से हुई है एंड 300 लेवल इज अगेन इट्स सप्लाई जोन. ओके सो एज ऑफ नाउ अगेन इन ज़ील Not much. Okay.
News based ऊपर किया है.
हाँ पूरा news था वो था निकला और बहुत चीजें इसमें. तो इसको भी छोड़ दे. News based होता है तभी सर इतना ऊपर जाता. नहीं तो चीजें एक एक धीरे धीरे ऊपर जाती हैं. ये एक ही दिन में
40% ऊपर गया.
वही तो ऐसे स्टॉक के बारे में क्या ही कहेंगे. Leave it same TV today.
Sir, I had deal half quantity.
कौन सा
गुड बुक दैट 20%
बढ़िया अच्छी बात. मेरे पास तो था भी नहीं. जागरण जागरण वाज बाय द वे बाय लास्ट वीक वी गिव डिड गुड. दिस टीवी वाज अ बाय वी गिव. दिस टीवी खरीदा था किसी ने. दिस टीवी वाज समथिंग आल्सो आई वाज जस्ट टोल्ड यू गाइस क्लियर कट बाय है. देखो अच्छा इसमें 15-20% बना. But again, they got this TV. If you again, you guys see now, so it is also near its supply zone. Okay, so this week, mein yaar rates bahut kam hai. Bahut kam trades hain. Pure media sector mein bhi ek bhi clear cut trade nahi hai. Reality mein dekhte hain. Reality mein Sentec is good. This thing is not good. That's so that looks good. So guys, look to buy Sova. Okay, if Sova tomorrow starts going up above this level of 785, look to buy Sova. This is 9. समझो यहाँ पे है एल एन टी. देखो आपको डाइवर्जेंस दिख रही है इतनी डाइवर्जेंस बट दिस कंटिन्यूड दिस अप मूव स्टिल अ बेयरिश. दिस होल स्ट्रक्चर इज अ बेयरिश स्ट्रक्चर. ओके दिस इज नॉट अ बुलिश पैटर्न but still it's moving up. Okay, now if anyone could have gone short here, you would have been making a big loss. So that's why I say ki complex structures are not the structures where you should take a positional view. Similarly, a person who has went long here, he cannot be very confident ki haan ye upar jayega. He has to trail his stops very tightly, and this is what you guys have to do in Bank Nifty. If in Bank Nifty you go long, trail your stops very tightly. But same, this again looks a bearish structure, not very bullish. So again, in this same similar call will be there. If you go long, trail your stops tightly. The moment it breaks this trend line, we will see a badhiya correction, and this would be the bigger trade which we will be looking for. IBDL, nothing. MSTR, nothing. Godrej. Godrej looks good again. Yeah. Godrej looks good. Again, in Godrej, you have a divergence. We are for trading here. DLF, pretty good. Financials. So SBI Life is good, guys. This is something which you guys can buy for next week. Looks good. Okay. So SBI Life, you guys can buy. Keep a stop of 1154. Near the stop of 1154, you need to buy as close as this point. Okay. So again, on Monday, if you see a little bit of downtick, then look to grab this one. Obviously not good. PFC struggling to stay at the top. Okay, so again, not good. PL looks good. PL is looking good. PL is looking actually very good. Yeah. Stop with my Aska. So देखो ये flag and pole pattern type है, so that's why I'm saying PL looks good. This is again something which can be bought. Stop loss थोड़ा बड़ा है, almost आपका 80-90 point का stop loss है. So daily chart में देखते हैं, yes this would be your stop. Good. So PL guys you can buy. आज का जो low है उसको stop डाल के PL is something you can look to enter. M&M Finance. Good. Not good. General Insurance. One, two, three, four, five. Chola can be bought. आज बहुत कम बारिश है, होनी भी नहीं चाहिए. नहीं तो फिर सब बारिश रहेगा तो फिर नेक्स्ट वीक कहाँ है कब बारिश? 592 का स्टॉप डाल के चोला इज वन थिंग विच यू गाइस कैन बाय. Bajaj Finance, Bajaj Finserv, both are a clear cut failure and might go down in a massive way. So guys, देखो बहुत कम trades हैं इस week. If you see, I guess there was one SBI Life, okay, which was a trade. Then PL, which you can buy, and Chola. These three in finance, reality में almost nothing. L&T is something which you can buy but risky, be cautious about that. फिर मीडिया में कुछ नहीं, FMCG में मिड वीक देखना है, सब सपोर्ट पे खरीदना है, जिसमें से सारे जो भी सपोर्ट के पास है सब लेना है. फार्मा में कुछ नहीं है, बैंकिंग में सिर्फ कोटेक, अगेन नियर द सपोर्ट नॉट एट द हाइज. ऑटो में अगेन टीवीएस को छोड़ के ऑलमोस्ट सारे ही अच्छे हैं. एक्साइड, हीरो एंड टाटा आर द बेस्ट.
बजाज,
हाँ एक्साइड बजाज और टाटा, नॉट हीरो. ठीक है, देन मेटल्स में नथिंग. ऑल ऑफ द मेटल्स तो एकदम खरीदना ही नहीं है गलती से भी. आईटी में भी अगेन सारे अच्छे हैं ऑलमोस्ट. ठीक है, सबको आपको खरीदना है. इधर ट्रेंड लाइन क्रॉसेस क्रॉस करने पे या सपोर्ट के पास, तो ऑलमोस्ट आई तो आई टी नेक्स्ट वीक में बाइंग के लिए क्या है, बस आपके पास आई टी है, एफएमसीजी नियर सपोर्ट एंड देन फ्यू स्टॉक्स हियर एंड देयर, दैट्स इट. एंड दैट्स अगेन कंफर्म्स आवर व्यू दैट नेक्स्ट वीक वी आर एक्सपेक्टिंग द वीक टू बी अ लिटिल बिट बेयरिश, दैट वुड बी द व्यू. ओके, स्टॉक्स देख लेते हैं इधर, बाकी जो बचे हुए हैं इंडिगो. बाय द वे इंडिगो में आज मैंने ट्रेड लिया था, एक्चुअली ये इतनी जल्दी ऊपर आया कि मैं आप लोग कॉल नहीं दे पाया. आई टेल यू वेयर आई वाज गिविंग वॉइस कॉल, दिस वाज द ब्लैक पैटर्न, और मैंने सोचा कि ये जो ट्रेंड लाइन क्लोज होगा देन आई विल गिव यू गाइस कॉल. प्रॉब्लम ये हुआ कि ये क्लोज होते होते काफी ऊपर चला गया, देन आई कुडंट गिव यू गाइस कॉल. मेरा एसएलएम ऑर्डर था, एग्जीक्यूट हो गया, बट आई कुडंट गिव यू गाइस कॉल. सो इंडिगो मेड गुड मनी टुडे फॉर मी. Okay, so this would be something again in my watch list. It's there. We'll see next week. If we find something, I'll give you guys. But as of now, don't get into it also. Okay? Saafi bad chuka hai. Baki stocks itna IRCTC is also good. IRCTC with... Ab dekho, IRCTC ka chart dekho. Jaise Bank Nifty ka chart tha, L&T ka chart tha. IRCTC ke chart mein dekho, agar aap RSI, continuously increase, so there is no drop in momentum. Okay, this is a very bullish pattern, but this is the type of pattern you can buy. But if you see the difference between this chart and the Bank Nifty L&T chart is this momentum, though there are new highs, you don't see the momentum rising. Yeah, so that is the reason I'm not confident on them. This is something which you can still buy. Okay, Dabur, PFC, HDFC, ICICI, Bharti Airtel. एयरटेल में तो मिड वीक मैंने कॉल दिया था आप लोगों को, एयरटेल स्टिल लुक्स गुड, बट अभी अब नेक्स्ट कंसोलिडेशन पे विल बाय. हैवेल्स वाज अ बाय लास्ट वीक, दैट गुड. अपोलो टायर को गाइस वॉच लिस्ट पे रखना फॉर नेक्स्ट वीक. ओके, दिस इज समथिंग व्हिच कैन गिव अस अ ब्रेकआउट. ओके, keep that in watch list. Voltas was also a buy call last week, again gave good money, but those who are riding it, they can continue holding. Those who have not entered, they cannot get an entry. नया मीडिया कहाँ गया भाई? Titan was a buy last week. So guys, not much trades this week, okay? Not much trades. We'll see now next week. Close karte aaj ka webinar. I also have to run. Sorry that we did not do a very detailed webinar this time. Okay, but good thing is ki this week's webinar is also coinciding with a time when we don't actually have much trades also. So that's even better. Zyada mehnat bhi nahi karni padi. Theek hai, kuch miss bhi nahi hua. Because kuch hai bhi nahi karne ko aise bhi. So next week, just be cautious, guys. And in fact, you know, if you guys want to take 1 week off, just take the next week off. Don't trade at all in next week, okay? Next week will be a bit tricky. And if you don't trade, higher chances are you will save some money. And money saved is also something equal to money being made, okay? So people who are not very good at trading, you know, or just avoid next week trading. Okay, don't trade in next week. Book out your profits. अच्छे profit book किया ही है already आप लोगों ने. रखो एक week रखो. अगला week pass होने दो. And अगला week जैसे ही pass होगा, we will see dollar index, you know, near the top by the end of the next week. Okay, and once that is done, we'll look at again, you know, this part of the dollar index or this part. So we'll have a definite move. Either we are going short or long. Okay, so the coming week, try and avoid if you can. Okay, don't be a compulsive trader because there are very few trades and the whole market is bearish. Buying something will be difficult. Similarly, we cannot sell it because again, in a bullish market, selling is also something which is not good. So next week will be tricky, and I'll suggest mostly that you guys avoid trading next week. Yeah, you should know when to trade, when not to. Chalo guys, any questions, anyone? Chalo, if nothing is there, we'll close it now for today. Thank you guys. Bye-bye. Take care
Thank
of
you,
yourself.
Sir.
Yeah.
Have fun.
Thanks. कोई fun नहीं भाई, बहुत काम है.
Third trip weekend में.
अरे weekend trip नहीं है यार, काम है, business का काम है, not fun. Anyway, चलो guys, take care of yourself. Bye-bye.